I'm Eqbal Mohammed Abdu Dauqan from Yemen. I'm coming from Taiz city. It is a beautiful city in Yemen. I finished my school and master in Taiz, and then I moved to Malaysia to continue my PhD and then postdoc. Then back to Yemen to continue my academic journey, and I was working with a private university, a side university, and then because of the war, I went again to Malaysia. So after that, I moved to Norway. My childhood was really very nice because I was really naughty, and I liked to have a fun and play. The people around me and my family, they never imagined that I will be a scientist in future. And then after the school, I asked them, because during the school I never liked chemistry course. But after I finished my school, I asked my family that in the university I want to study chemistry, and they are shocked really. And they said, you don't like it, chemistry, that's why my father and my cousin went to the university and registered me as a physics. And then I just asked them, please, I want to study chemistry. And then they went to the university and changed my field to chemistry. I graduated from the university with a very good degree. And then I asked my father that I want to continue my higher education. The secret of my success in my academic journey is my family, my parents, my sister, my father, and all my family. They encourage me to study whatever I want at whatever I love to study. That's why he encouraged me to continue my master in chemistry. So I studied my master in organic chemistry in Taiz University. I faced a lot of challenges during my master journey because I studied my master in Taiz University, and we have lack of equipment. Sometime after each experiment, I should send my result to Egypt to do some analysis, and then I should wait 3 or 4 months for the results. We have lack in the chemicals. I should take a long time to receive some chemicals. It was really terrible time for me. I took my master in 5 years. It's not because I'm not hard working, it's because the condition around me. But I was at the same time teaching in the university, so I was enjoying my journey that time. I told my colleagues that, I'm thinking to continue my PhD outside Yemen, and they are just laughing. They said, just continue your master first. Just, they are kidding with me, and they never trust me that I can do it. But I love to do something difficult until now. Just challenge the people around me. I applied for a PhD scholarship from OST, and then I got it. I traveled to Malaysia and finished my PhD there. And I was the first student, national and foreigner, got excellent thesis in this field. And until now, nobody got it. So I'm proud of myself. And I received a postdoc, to continue my postdoc, as award from the university. And I stayed there for 1 year to continue my postdoc. After that, I went to Yemen. Directly, I got position as a senior lecturer in private university, a side university. After a few months, they selected me to be head of one department. When I went to Yemen, I carry with me idea that I want to open nutrition department or anything nutrition for my city or for my country. And then I wrote a strong proposal, and I applied for, I sent it for our rector, and I asked them, really, I need to open this program. He agreed with me, and then we invite some professor from Malaysia. We did a workshop, and then figure out the name or the title of this department. It was therapeutic nutrition, and we opened it. When I finished my PhD in Malaysia and I went back to Yemen, I really love myself because I can contribute something what I was dreaming when I was in Malaysia. First of all, I can manage to open the new department about the nutrition, and at the same time, I receive an award as a young scientist in the developing world. So I was proud of myself because I can do what the people around me say, you cannot do it. And the second thing, I did the first exhibition or nutrition exhibition in my city. A lot of people attend from inside and outside the university. It was staff, students, academic people, and also government people come and attend my exhibition. But unfortunately, it was the last academic activity for me in Yemen. After a few days, the war started in my country. So I should stay at home because the way over the road, it's become very dangerous. I stay at home for 8 months without anything, you know, working, so scared, so worried. And it was not in our own home. It was a rental apartment outside of our city center. There is no electricity, no water, no internet. We are all the time very worried because it's bombed from airstrike, from another rocket in the city. So it was not safe place, no food. It was really terrible time. But I tried 8 months. For me, it was really difficult. I cannot stay without working. I cannot stay with this situation. I tried all my best to contact with my former boss or supervisor in Malaysia to help me. What can I do? But unfortunately, I don't have electricity to charge my laptop, to charge my mobile. What I can do, just take my mobile to my car. I have a little bit of petrol just to charge my mobile. And I was worried about the oil or the petrol in my car because I should keep it if we should run away again. So I just charged my mobile and sent to her message to help me. And really she helped me to apply for fellowship from Scholar Rescue Fund in America, and I got it. I traveled to Kuala Lumpur, but after that the airport bombed, so my family there in Yemen until now. Before my 2 years finished in Malaysia, I was really under stress. So, but where you will go now? Because I know in my country, the situation is still not good because of the war. I contacted or sent email to the scholar at risk. Please help me, how can I find another opportunity to continue my academic journey and support my family? And I explained my situation because it was urgently. I should go out from Malaysia. And then they are very helpful people. They replied at the same time, just send us your CV and documents. We will try to help you. And really they helped me. And then I receive feedback that Eqbal, you got a position as associate professor in University of Agder. And from this I start to, oh, okay, I'm going to Norway. I was worried from the culture, weather, language, religion, everything different for me. But when I arrived in Norway, I was surprised because the people really very kind. They received me very well. From the first year, I said, yes, Eqbal, it's really the right place they chose for me. So when the war started, I lost a lot of things in my life, like members in my family, my work. Some of my students killed, some of my friends killed. And of course, my family also, they never receive until now any government salaries. We are 5 sisters, 2 brothers, and my father engineer, and he had before a good position in the government, but now nothing, and there is no government salaries. I have 1 PhD sister, she is a lecturer in the university, and 2 medical doctors. My brothers, both of them engineer, but because of the war, the situation is so bad. So I'm working now to support also my family. It's not just to continue my academic journey, but also to support my family. So our situation, we are as, for example, for all the people in Yemen because of the war, WHO report that every 4 minutes, 1 child in Yemen died because of hunger. So at least my family, they are living in the, I cannot say safe, but safer than the city center or another place in Yemen. And I'm trying all my best to support them. I hope the war stop in Yemen because it's really so bad. The outcome really very difficult for the people there. So for me, I hope the war, first of all, I hope the war stop. And then we as educated people, academic people outside Yemen, we hope to go back in Yemen and rebuild our country. I faced in my life, in my academic journey, a lot of challenges, a lot of difficulties. Yes, we are human, sometimes we are weak, but we never give up. Please don't forget Yemen.